When we think of mummies, the first thing that comes to our head is the ancient Egyptians and how they preserved their dead for the afterlife. But there are a group of people that have been mummifying their dead around 2,000 years earlier than the Egyptians. They are known as the Chinchero. First things first, I'm going to talk about what we know about the ancient Chinchero people and their way of life. After that, we'll look into the Chinchero mummies and what they can tell us. The Chinchero people can be described as a small group of fishermen who lived along the South American coast in the Atacama Desert in northern Chile and southern Peru. The earliest archaeological sites can date the Chinchero people as far back as 7,000 BC or 9,000 years ago. Most of the Chinchero sites are found along the coast, but some sites are found closer inland. Evidence shows they lived in huts and small family groups with a total population of around 30 to 50 people. At the site known as Kiana 9, dated to around 4,420 BC, the Chinchero were shown to have lived in hut houses with roofs made of mammal skin. What is interesting about the location is that the huts were built on the slope of an Arica coastal hill. Other sites like Caleta Huelia 42, near the mouth of the Loa River, had some huts that were partially underground with floors on top, which hints at them being used for some time. Now the question is, why did they choose to live in the Atacama Desert of all places? It turns out the Atacama Desert has a very interesting climate cycle. The climate is known to flip-flop. Around 3,800 and 10,000 years ago, the first people began to settle in the desert. It is around this time of a wet phase that resulted in higher water levels and more plants. Around 9,500 years ago, the climate changes and it gets hot and dry, which likely led to the abandonment of the settlement to seek out a better location. Around 7,000 and 6,700 years ago, there was a transition back to another wet phase, which made the people settle down yet again. It is important to note that the climate fluctuations play a big part in how the Chinchero lived. Now that we got to learn a little about the Chinchero people, there is something that sets them apart from other cultures, and that is the way they mummified their dead. The Chinchero mummies were found in 1917 by Max Uhle, a German archaeologist who can be seen as the father of archaeology in South America. Over 282 mummies have been found over the years. 133 of the mummies found were natural mummies, which are bodies preserved under the right conditions. In this case, the mummies were in the dry climate of the Atacama Desert. The oldest of the natural mummies is known as the Achaman, who is around 9,000 years old. What we're looking for are the artificial mummies, which are when the Chinchero started to mummify their dead. This is around 7,000 years ago, which is crazy. The oldest artificial Chinchero mummy was dated to around 5,500 BC. When looking into the mummification process, there are three clear styles over the thousands of years. First being the black style. This style of mummification is dated around 5,050 to 2,500 BC. The black style is considered the most complex process. The entire body is skinned, and all the organs and muscles are taken out. The bones are reinforced with sticks, and the body is filled in with reeds and clay. The skin is placed back on the body. A mask is placed on the head, which includes a wig of human hair. The mask was given a sleeping expression, and the rest of the body was covered in an ash paste and black manganese. The next style is known as the red style, which starts around 2500 BC and lasts for around 500 years. At this point, manganese is phased out for red ochre. The mummification process has changed. The internal organs, muscles, and brains are removed and replaced with reeds, clay, and sticks. But the facial expressions change on the mask to suit a figure that is alert and lively. It's not sure why they made this change. Maybe it was made to accompany a new generation of the craft. The bodies were sewn back together with human hair using a cat-to-spine needle, which I might add was a very clever use of what they had at their disposal. The bodies also show signs of burning, which may hint at them being dried out with hot coals. In the third style, which is around 2000 BC, the mummification stops and the bodies are dried out and covered in a thick layer of mud and then buried. So as a whole, what does the Chinchero's practice of mummification tell us? Unlike the ancient Egyptians, the Chinchero mummified all their dead, whether they are rich or poor, and even children and the unborn. We have to think mummifying their dead took a lot of their time, especially when they were living in such a harsh environment. There are no written records or pottery found to explain why they made such an effort. On the black and red mummies, there is evidence of repairs done. This may suggest that the bodies were kept around other family members. The mummies have many other interesting things to say. For one, there is evidence to say that all was not so peaceful. There was blunt force trauma found on the skulls of some of the mummies, suggesting clashes between rival groups, which is not a surprise given their struggle for resources. Another thing, what did they do with the flesh and organs they removed from the bodies? It is a possibility that they partook in cannibalism, and there is some evidence of this in the documentary called The Oldest Mummies in the World. They found a bone that was cut vertically, which could suggest that the person who made the cut wanted to get at the bone marrow inside. It could be possible that the act of cannibalism in the Chichiro's time could have been seen differently, maybe a way to be one with the dead, or maybe they were just a little too hungry that day. Another interesting to take away from the Chichiro mummies is the presence of Chagas disease. This is an infectious disease that is caused by the parasite T. cruzi. If left untreated, it can cause heart and digestive problems. In the early Chichiro period, from 7050 to 3000 BC, 18 bodies were tested and 39% were positive for Chagas disease. In 3000 to 1500 BC, known as the late Chichiro period, 53 bodies were tested and 43% were positive. Even in the Inca civilization, from 1450 to 1550 AD, had a 50% positive rating from 26 bodies. This is just to show how much of an impact disease played in early human societies. I have to admit, it's pretty amazing how much can be learned from studying the Chichiro mummies, but they have had a rough time in recent years. In 2015, an article was published on PRI.org, which talks about Chile's changing climate affecting the Chichiro mummies. The climate became more humid, which allowed microorganisms to grow and eat at the mummy's skin. Luckily, a new museum is set to open in 2020 to house the mummies in the proper conditions, and hopefully everything is under control. If not, we need to remember the Chichiro mummies, as they are key to understanding early humans in South America. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, leave a like. It really helps me out. And if you haven't already, subscribe for more history content, and I'll see you guys in the next one.